things. We've just got to match that brand issue with the place.
I do feel a bit demoralised. I sort of feel like, unless you change the overall structure of an organisation, like Interpolis did, giving power, devolving power, I just don't see how anything else can change. Architecture can only reflect the society it's born into. And if that society doesn't change, architecture won't fundamentally change. You'll just be fiddling around the edges. A pot plant here, a pot plant there, isn't going to make a difference in the long run. You've got to change a whole culture, a whole workplace culture. In the early 1970s, Britain faced a choice. Would we embrace American-style workplaces, as championed by Norman Foster and all the architects that subsequently copied him? Or was there another way?
If only British architects like Foster had looked to Europe instead of America back then, everything might have been so different. There's one building here in the Dutch town of Apeldoorn that pointed the way. Centraal Beheer, designed by the visionary architect Herman Hertzberger.
Now this is the kind of building I think is a real icon of architecture. And this guy over here, he's the real superstar of architects.
Do it, but they are waiting for us.
Is Professor Hertzberger famous in China?
Yeah!
Wow, that is... Look at this, it's like being with Madonna or something.
This building, a stack of perfect cubes on the outside, seems like it might be quite simple on the inside. In fact, the cubes create an intricate space. Just trying to find your way around this labyrinth can be confusing, but it's also incredibly stimulating to wander over the terraces and the tiers. It's the complete opposite of a bland, open-plan office.
The idea was to make it a city, and to make it sort of outside.
Yeah.
The light coming from above, the material of streets, and this has the feeling of a Mediterranean city.
Yeah. These workspaces have very low ceilings. Feels almost cozy, but they also encourage concentration. That's why operating tables have low ceilings above them as well. But when you want to break free from your desk and have a brainstorm, there are always balconies perched out onto this beautiful atrium with natural light flooding down and stimulating sights and sounds everywhere.
The thinking was to make individual working places, yet having communication, making it all together one social space. The important thing is we worked very hard on the acoustics. Mm. People can talk and you're not too much distracted.
Uniquely, when this building opened, the staff were asked to completely furnish their workspaces themselves.
So did you come up with the idea of people bringing their own furniture, their own stuff,
yeah,
and knickknacks?
At that time, that was the end of the 60s, that was a need, an urge for people to show their identity. And they were sort of competing each other with things, with animals. They brought in birds and animals and things. There's one thing I know, that is that the restaurant was so popular that people who used to go home to their wives for lunch stayed in the building. And of course, there were very many relationships because you see each other all the time. And so this was going to be very free.
Yeah.
And it caused also marriage problems.
Really? The building caused marriage problems? You're to blame.
I was to blame.
This is what architecture should be. It should be a three-dimensional, stimulating, tactile, human thing. It shouldn't just be about the look of it.
Many architects, they get strokes from God, you know. And then you know what. This doesn't work that way. It's not the structure that is important, but what people can do with it. Mm.
Can you talk a little bit about where that idea came from?
Where did this idea disappear is for me a more interesting question, because of course the user is, you know, you're not doing it for yourself, you're doing it to make the life possible.
And a whole lifetime in this building was also possible. 40 years after they appeared in this wonderful footage shot here at Centraal Beheer, two of the original staff have only just moved out of the building.
So did you love the building when you moved in?
Yes.
Yeah, directly.
Directly.
What did you love about it? What was it?
It's nice. It is warm, like a living room.
What did it feel like to move out, to not work here?
Crying.
Yeah.
Did you?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Part of your... It's like what you have with a birth. What's an alpha string?
Cutting the cord.
And this was also here.
Wow.
So whose fault is it we've ended up with these broken spaces? Too many architects designed for this moment, the perfect idealized space on the inside, iconic form on the outside. But put the people in here, and it just doesn't work. Since the 80s, capitalism's forces into workplaces as controlling as prisons. And I could blame the architects, but they've just been weak, responding to market forces, designing shiny-skinned icons rotten to the core, like the Shard, next year's architectural event. But I blame you and me just as much. We've been too easily impressed by these glittering jewels, too happy to relinquish our freedoms to bosses who carry on building the same old stuff. If you're bored of the architecture in your life, take control of a building by designing a school with the Open University. Go to channel4.com/buildings and follow the links.